Hello everyone, we are going to see a Docker architecture. Docker architecture follow a client server architecture. So here we will be having the Docker client and Docker server, and that is called as a Docker host. In Docker architecture, we have three main parts. One is a client, Docker host, and registry. Docker client provide a command line interface, that is CLI. This tool help us, that is CLI, interact with a Docker daemon and help us to perform number of actions. So that action can be a pull, a push, a run. So number of things we can perform. So in upcoming our session, we are going to see how we can use the Docker client to perform an action. All right. So we cannot directly do any operation without a Docker client. So when you start the Docker daemon, by default, Docker client get started, and you can use that Docker client to interact with a Docker daemon. Docker daemon have two responsibility, majorly to manage a containers and the images. Now in the diagram, we can see that there is a Ubuntu image in the image section, and Docker daemon using that image to create a container. So why we need to use that image and create a container? For any developer, for any operation to deploy any application, we need an operating system. And that image is read-only image. So we cannot write anything on that image. Until and all, we use that image and deploy the container. So that is very important to use the image and create a container. Because container adds a read-write layer on that image. So anyone can write a data on that image. I mean, can modify that image or can add another layer to top of that image. Basically, the image is a layered. So number of layers are there. For example, you created something and you save it to the version one. Again, you created something, you save it to the version two. So the version one having the layer one and version two having the layer two. All right. So n number of layer you can keep creating on that image. So in upcoming lectures, we are going to see how we can create an image, how we can reuse an image, how we can create n number of image and use that image for creating a container. All right. Next part is registry. In registry, we can see that n number of images which is already created and which is already stored there. What is a registry and why we need that? Very important. Now, everyone need a thing should be a fast, agile, right? So for example, I need a database server, MySQL server. I'm not going to install the operating system, maybe Ubuntu or CentOS or any Linux-based operating system. And top of that, I have to install the MySQL server. I have to do the hardening. And after that, I have to start the services and all. All right. If someone asks me, I have created a operating system for you. I have already installed the MySQL on that. I have already done the hardening. You can check it out and you can use for your purpose. Oh, wow. So for me, I do not have to kill my time to installing the operating system, to installing the SQL server and all. I can directly take that image from the registry. So most of the organization, most of the community, they are working with a Docker to create and their image and load into the official site of Docker. So if you get any image from the official site, so that image are tested by that vendor. Let's say example, you want to download the CentOS recent image, that is CentOS 3.7.3, or you want to download the recent Ubuntu image, or you want to download the Java or Python. So all the images are available on the Docker Hub, that is we call as a registry. And Docker Hub is very smart. You do not have to do much more configuration to connect with Docker Hub. Just you want to create your account and you have to run set of few commands on your Linux box that is from the Docker host, and you will easily get connected with your Docker Hub. So when you type any command from the client, like for example, Docker pull, it will go to the Docker daemon. That call will go to the Docker daemon. And Docker daemon use your credential that you are already set up on the Docker host machine. It will use your credential. It will log in on the Docker Hub and pull that image which you have asked for. And the important thing for image, there are the different versions of the image. In the Docker term, we call it as a tag. So you can attach the tag to that image. So for example, let's say I am a developer. I want to build an application and my application is a Go on, for example. So I can build an application Go on. For example, I will give the version one. So this will be the tag version one. Maybe other developer want to do the some improvement in the application and want to tag as a version two. They can tag it. Let's say example, I want to now work on the previous version. No problem. When I'm pulling the image, I just give the tag version one. So it will come the previous image. If you want to go for the recent image, you just attach the tag version two. So in that way, you can have the multiple versions of images and you can easily store on the Docker Hub and you can use for your purpose anytime. It will be readily available on the Docker Hub. Now the points come here, how much time it takes to download the whole operating system? Because usually if you take any operating system, if it is a minimal, it will be around 300 to 600 MB. If it is a GUI based, then it will be around 3 to 6 GB. All right. But these images are very lightweight. These images are very lightweight because all the binaries, all the libraries are not with this operating system. This will going to lie with your host. All the binaries, all the libraries which you already have on the Docker host, it will again not going to be in the image. It will be only the functions to run that container. So it will going to use your base operating system libraries and binaries to start or to make the container up and running. So it are very, very lightweight. So when you pull it, you will see that in a fraction of minutes, it will going to download it and you can easily create a container and start your work. So I will just give the real time example where we can use the Docker Hub. Let's say example, I want the Python 3.4. All right. So Python 3.4, what I can do, I can install the operating system. Top of that, I can install the Python 3.4. I can do the environment setup and all, right? But if I need, I just type the in the Docker Hub Python 3.4, the image will be there. So just I can pull it from the Docker daemon and I can just write my code on the Python 3.4. So it saves a lot of time. This was the ideal scenario. But for the organization, how they are using it. Let's take example, I'm into the operation team. I want to do the some testing. All right. So I have the some test cases where I have to need this script, where I have to need this setting, where I need environment setting and all. There is a maybe n number of tasks that I have to perform in the operating system before starting the testing. So what I can do, I can create those scenario in my container and I can build that container into an image. So I will build the image and save it to the Docker Hub. All right. So Docker Hub, there is option. You can keep publicly and private. So this kind of thing I'm definitely going to keep as a private because it's not public. It's limited to that organization. All right. So maybe after 1 month, again, someone want to do that same testing. I do not want to again give my lot of time to create those scenario, which is already I have created and save into the form of image on the Docker Hub. All right. So what I will do, I will just download that image. I will create another container for that image. I will start my test. So it will save a lot of time to do the testing, to do the environment setup, to install the script, or to install any basic softwares into that Docker. All right. Now, next question arises. If I done a lot of job into the my container and container having some issue, what I have to do? It's a very right question. In that case, we have to create a build file that is called as a Docker file. Docker file is used to create a container based on the code. For example, if you write set of code into that Docker file, it will going to deploy your container as you written in the code. So that will be our next discussion, how we are going to use the Docker file to do our job in a smarter way, in a less time, and we do not have to bother about if any problems comes, how we can going to rebuild the same environment. So that Docker file going to help us to do that job. But one question is here, if we are using a Docker file, then is it necessary to preserve our container? Really not. If you've done your job, just delete it. It's not at all required, because all the setting you are written into the code. So just you have to run the code and it will create same as it is previously you were have the container. So for example, you have 10 number of job you have written in the file, you've created a container, and after that your container is deleted. In that case, no problem. I can use my Docker file, I will recreate it. So it is like a use and throw. Once your job is done, just delete it out, or you do not have to bother it. You have the file, you have the registry, that is Docker Hub, no problem. It will pull the appropriate image, what you have written in the file. It will download the appropriate application. It will do the appropriate environment setup. It will perform the necessary things, what you have written in the file, and your container is ready to go. So in that way, we can use the three component to do our job. So nowadays, where we can use this kind of models? Most of the developers already using the Docker container technology. Most of the cloud team using the Docker container technology to do their testing, to do their infra test, to their microservices, to do their number of jobs that can be save the time, that can be save the repetitive works. We can use the Docker container technology. So in short, what are the benefit of Docker container? All right. So there are the n number of benefit we already discussed in our previous slide, right? So Docker daemon help us to perform the n number of job for us. So Docker daemon, basically the name of the daemon is Docker D. So it is always running on the Linux kernel Docker D, and that listen for the client calls, and the clients give the number of jobs to the Docker daemon. And Docker registry, we discuss, it's a Docker hub where we have the n number of images which is already there, and we can pull it, we can push it, or we can use it. And the images is a read-only format. So image can be any application image, maybe Apache image, maybe Java image, maybe your CentOS image, maybe Python image. So you can bundle the things into that image and you can upload it to the Docker Hub. So later on, you can use that image to perform your job. All right. So thank you for watching it.